Kumar Sen, and in this video tutorial you are going to learn about heat engine numerical problems, right? So heat engine numerical problems already asked in GATE previous year. They usually what do? They always ask maybe heat engine or maybe heat pump or maybe refrigerator. These three things are most important for GATE. They can relate these things with each other or maybe they can ask in separate, just like this question asks separately. If you know the concept of heat engine, then you can easily solve the question. Okay, now let me first draw the heat engine, because this is a question of heat engine. So always remember one thing: if you are talking about heat engine, refrigerator, even heat pump, even BCRS cycle, even BERS cycle, even Brayton cycle, now Brayton cycle is okay, that is different, BCRS cycle, then you need to draw the diagram. Okay, even if you are solving question of steady flow energy equation, if you will draw the diagram, then things will become quite easier for you to understand and to solve the problem with maintaining accuracy. Okay, so what they have given in this question, we'll talk on that topic. So a cycle of heat engine does 50 kilojoule of work per cycle. Okay, so work done is 50 kilojoule, got it? Now let's say this is like this. The direction would be like this, because this is a case of heat engine and this is a source, this is sink, you can say that. Okay, so the efficiency of heat engine, so again said the efficiency is 75%, that means 75 by 100, that means 0.75, got it? Now talk about this, let's talk about the another thing, that is here only. So if we are getting these things here, that means we have to find out heat rejected per cycle is. Heat rejected per cycle. Okay, remember that. Heat rejected per cycle. So how the heat is rejecting per cycle, that is important. We need to find out that. So okay. Now heat rejected per cycle means how much heat is rejecting per cycle. That means what is the value here. Okay, so let's say this is QH and this is QL. We have to find out QL according to the question. Okay, now unit, check it in unit we have given in kilojoule and we have to find out kilojoule, so we don't have any problem with the unit system. Now relate things with efficiency and work done, work output, right? We know that efficiency, there is one formula that is universal in terms of heat, that is output by input. And if we wanted to relate this in terms of heat, then we can say that work done by work input, right? Now what is work done here? 50. And work input, we don't know, that is I am saying here QH. Okay, now just send this one to this side and this one to this side, this will be in reciprocal in the denominator only. So QH is equal to 50.75, right? So do it here, 50 division 0.75 is equal to 66.666 and kilojoule. This is not the answer here. They have given option, most probably the it can match with the answer. Okay, so I mean maybe it can match the answer. So let's do this. Okay, 66 multiple 2 plus 3 division 2, yeah, almost it's same, matching with the answer. So this is not the actually right answer, because what we have find out till now, that is QH is equal to 66.666, okay, kilojoule. But we have to find out this one. So we know that again incoming is equal to outgoing, incoming heat is equal to outgoing. So incoming is only 166.666 and outgoing is how there to 50 plus QL. We have to find out QL, just a second, QL, right? Now send this 50 to this side, so what will get? QL is equal to 66.6666 minus 50 is equal to 16.6666 and kilojoule, got it? Now what is the answer here? 16.666. okay, now look at the option we have given, there is also problem, but you can use calculator. So use 16 multiple 2 plus 3 division 2, this is not the right answer. So check on this one, 16 multiple 3 plus 2 50 division 3, yeah, 16.666. so this is the right answer for this question. So whenever you are getting question about anything which is having diagram, then don't forget to draw diagram. You know why? Because diagram play most important role to understand its concept. If I did solve the question without drawing a diagram, then probably understanding things like this one, and we can do this one, but this one would be much tougher. We could mark the answer A is the right answer if we did not draw the diagram. Now you can understand the importance of drawing diagram, at least if any question is having diagram. So thanks for watching. Thank you very much, and hope to see you again in my next video. 12. Bye bye.